This is Ken Willis of Cadence Design Systems. This demonstration will cover the new SystemSI Test Bench module, which debuts in July 2014 with the ASI 16.64 release. Joining the parallel bus and serial link analysis modules in the SystemSI product family, the Test Bench module is targeted for general SI tasks. It provides an SI sandbox for pre- and post-route analysis using IBIS, SPICE, Touchstone or BNP S parameter models. Its wire-based connectivity use model makes it very easy to connect up your own custom topologies, and it provides DC, AC, and transient analysis. SystemSI test bench is invoked the same way as the parallel bus and the serial link analysis modules. You can select to start either from a blank canvas, or you can start from a predefined template. There's several in the installation, and you can add your own templates as you wish. So we're going to select a template, give the project a name, and that will copy it to our local directory where we can work on it. This particular topology is for one signal going through a W element from transmitter to receiver with pull-up termination at the far end. So we've loaded an existing workspace. You can add new blocks with either differential or single-ended signals. And the next step would be to assign IBIS models to the transmitter and receiver. So you double click on the transmitter, click Load IBIS, and here's where you would browse your new IBIS file and select the component that you want to assign here. You can also launch the IBIS editor, take a look at the model content, edit it, look at the curves, and so forth. The next step would be to edit the interconnect models along the way between the transmitter and receiver. So here we have one trace model in the topology. If you double click that, you can launch the T-Line editor and make modifications to the stack up or any of the parameters in this particular model. And to complete this, we've got the pull-up termination at the far end. With the test bench setup complete, the next step is to go set up for simulation and click Analysis Options. Here we'll select SpeedSim as the circuit simulator. Use custom simulation names, typical corner, and go in and set the data rate, the number of bits that you want to simulate, and whatever particular stimulus pattern you want to use. The next step is to run our transient analysis, which we can run right from the workflow. We can give it a unique simulation name and click OK, and the simulation will run. It's very easy in this environment to run multiple what-if scenarios. So here what we'll do is go in and remove the termination and rerun the simulation. We can give this a new simulation name and compare the results to the original one. As you would expect, the signal quality has suffered a little bit with the removal of that termination. But to save power, we may want to try a different approach. So in this case, we're going to delete this connection and go back and add a different type of termination. This time, we'll go in and try a series termination, which would be better on power consumption and may be able to achieve a similar goal. So we can go in and set the characteristics of this termination for what we want. This will be a 22 ohm termination, and you can easily wire it in with the wire-based connectivity model that we have in SystemSI Test Bench, and then simply resimulate. We can give our simulation a name to make it easy to compare waveforms later. And our waveforms appear shortly after. This termination scheme gave us nice clean waveforms. We can go in and take a closer look and actually recall the waveforms from the previous simulation so we can compare. You can see the unterminated case has quite a bit of overshoot and undershoot. The far end termination case has also nice clean signals but a significantly reduced voltage swing. So you can choose and compare from these different results and select the termination scheme that's going to be best for your signal. For this next case, what we'll do is instead of starting with a template, we'll just start from a blank canvas and take a look at some of the different types of blocks that are available in SystemSI Test Bench. So we'll start from a blank canvas. And you can select blocks from the toolbar and place them directly into your canvas. When you place them in, they come with default models, so they will simulate right out of the box. So in this case, this is a block for a generic spice subcircuit. This is an S parameter block where you can put in either a touchstone or a BNP file. A VRM block if you want to add power to a non-ideal power topology. And a W element, which we've looked at already, that uses the T-line editor. We've also got a VIA model. This block is for discrete elements. Like the Terminator block, this discrete block has a number of different configurations with it. So let's zoom in and take a little bit closer look at this one. The default configuration is for a resistor. We can also make it an inductor, a capacitor, a series RLC, a parallel RLC, or an ideal T-line with impedance and prop delay characteristics. We also have the terminator block that we looked at previously. Now we'll build a custom topology, again from a blank canvas. So we'll drop down an IBIS transmitter model, and then a spice block. In this case, we actually have a detailed package model that came from ExtractIM. So we're going to name this block package, browse to the ExtractIM file, and assign that to this block. On the other side of that package model, we're going to put a transmission line. So we'll select the discrete block and go and configure it for an ideal T-line. We'll leave it for an impedance of 50 ohms and a prop delay of 1 nanosecond. Then to complete the path, we'll drop in our receiver and also add a far end termination. We can go in and set the parameters for this termination. We're going to set it for a termination voltage of 1.2 volts and a resistance of 120 ohms. Next, we'll go in and assign the specific IBIS model that we want to associate to this transmitter. So we browse for the IBIS file we want. And once we have that IBIS file, we select the component, if there's multiple components in the IBIS file. And from there, we can select the specific pins that we want in the topology. In this case, we're picking one of the single-ended pins. Now all we have to do is connect up the topology. So you can just click on a port and drag and connect it to the port on another block. Since the package model has many terminals in it, we have to go in and select the specific terminals that we want to connect up to. So this is easily done in the connection editor. We can connect up the signal from the transmitter to that of the package. And again, coming out of the package and connecting to the transmission line. The remaining blocks only have one signal in them, so SystemSI will automatically connect them up properly. But we can go and take a look at the connectivity anyways. With our topology wired up, we'll go back to the workflow, and we can see we've done all the test bench setup, and we're now ready to set up for simulation. So we go to the analysis options form, and we can set the data rate of interest. We want to run this at 2.4 gigabits per second. We'll set up to run 16 bits through this topology, and we'll define our own custom stimulus pattern. The IBIS model assigned to this transmitter uses a model selector, so there's multiple choices for which buffer can drive. In this case, we'll choose the 34 ohm output driver. Following the workflow, we can now go and run AC analysis if we choose. So if we click that, you can see the configuration from that transmitter to the receiver, We'll just run a few frequency points here to do a quick simulation. And this gives us our frequency response. Note that the magnitude, even at DC, starts out less than the full swing simply because of the far end termination in this particular topology. Next, we'll run our transient simulation. We still have custom naming turned on, so we have the ability to give this particular simulation a name. We'll call it ZOUT34. It's easy to experiment with different buffer selections, with the IBIS model having a model selector. So we can go back into the analysis options form, and this time we'll select the 40 ohm output impedance driver. Now we can go back, kick off another transient simulation, give it a unique name, and compare the results. As we saw before, it's easy to compare waveforms from previous simulations. Just go back and browse, turn on the signals you want to see. You can see that this second simulation has a little bit smaller swing due to the different output impedance. You can look at eye diagrams, waveforms, or split the screen either way. From the simulation results, you can also generate a report for your signal quality, eye quality, and delay metrics. In summary, the SystemSI product line adds a test bench module to the existing parallel bus and serial link analysis modules for general purpose SI tasks. This allows you to simulate pre and post layout topologies, starting with either a blank canvas or a predefined template. A set of building blocks are provided that run right out of the box with models already assigned to make it easy to build and wire up your own custom topologies. Models extracted from other Sigrity technologies like ExcitePI, ExtractIM, or PowerSI can drop right into SystemSI TestBench for simulation. For more information on SystemSI or any other Cadence product, please contact your local Cadence sales team or your Cadence channel partner in the region. You can also visit www.cadence.com. That concludes this demonstration. Thanks for watching.